Leaders have held a general meeting today with residents at Cook Olok in Lira City West Division over the increasing insecurity in the area. Cook Olok Market, which can accommodate hundreds of vendors, is currently abandoned due to insecurity. Thomas Odomok, the LC1 chairperson of Starch Factory B, says due to lack of police patrols, insecurity has increased in the area. I'm requesting leaders to operate the way we used to do back then, because if we do so, insecurity will be a thing of the past. We kindly request that police officers can be brought to guard the abandoned lockups. All these places surrounding us, the abattoir, the railway line, are all impassable at night.
That's why you are hearing us talk about that I've named this place as a gate. You know, when people are going for wedding, for traditional marriage, before you enter, you have to pay some fee. And for them, their fee, it has not been defined. When they get you, they remove everything, whatever you have in your pocket. So, me as the chairperson, I'm emphasizing that they should resume daily routine patrol. If they can start that patrol every day, this place, Starch Factory, will be okay.
Ivan Tenua, the DPC Lira City West Division, says they're working towards bringing back sanity in the region and they hope to reopen the market to vendors.
Why are we here today? It is security.
No, me, why don't you
come? Afanda has been very, very clear. Afanda Rasis has been very, very clear. We are not here to talk about Chelsea. We are here to talk about security. Let's get registered. The lodges, the video halls, the landlords. Landlords, put emphasis on landlords. Because they know these people. Emphasis on landlords. That comes in now with the bylaws. I was asking that these people work in a group. Where do they come from? It means they are within us. And we cannot handle such a situation? No, that is bullshit. I'm not entertaining that. But I land on you, we shall handle you.
The meeting was also attended by the city commissioner, Lawrence Egole, who vowed to do everything possible to make sure that security prevails. Egole asked the community to write down names of those they suspect to be criminals in the area. 50 names were raised. And it was realized that 4 of the people on this list were already in prison. Report compiled by Hudson Apunyo for the news.